slow. The number one problem with why people are not trading is because they don't think like the Japanese, who created the candlesticks in the first place. There's an app on everybody having their phone. Right? Everybody. Japanese candlestick patterns. Go to your Google Play Store, go to your Apple iStore now. I want somebody else to download it. If you don't mind download it now. You need it. Let me tell you why. The only difference between a winner and a loser, Japanese candlestick patterns, it's an app, is if you learn the patterns, nobody can mess with you when it comes to trading. If you learn the patterns, so I'm going to teach this. Can I teach this? Are y'all still with me? Dr. Bryant, I thought he had a dry erase, but I'm sure I'm going through this paper now. Okay. Are y'all ready? So, rule number one to trading candlesticks. Rule number what? All right. You must draw support and resistance lines on your chart. Have to. This is very important. You're going to put those moving averages on there, but you got to know your area support and resistance. Right? Now, to discover support and resistance, there are something called fractals. If we had it live, I'll show you how this is phenomenal. Once you learn this, it's all over. Guys, I turned his trading around in one session. It took one session for him to become a proficient trader. He already had the strategy. He didn't know how to read candlesticks. It's a perfect strategy. Every strategy is perfect. We do not know how to read candlesticks. And guys, if you're going to become a proficient trader, when Rachel comes here in Baltimore, one of her classes is just making sure that you draw candlestick patterns on an index card. Not watch it on your phone. That's the beginning. There's not a neurological connection until you draw it. And so we have people who draw these candlestick patterns on their charts, right? If you know what this candlestick pattern is, right? And you see a candlestick pattern like this, right? Well, this is a bull candle, and this is a bear candle, and you see this on an area of support or resistance, that once the candle comes up and wicks this area of resistance, and then you have a candle that forms like this, that next candle down here is your entry. Teaching him that one thing improved his trading. Because he just wanted to see how it responded to support resistance. When he took this entry, how many pips do you think I told him to get? Yes, my brother. Sure. So let's say this is a level of resistance. The resistance is the roof, and support is the floor. Now I got that in an IML Academy, right? Yeah. Right, that's the floor, or flow, if you're from the south. So what happens is you'll have candles that go up like this, as a bull or buyers. So the candle's going up, right? It hits this level of resistance and it wicks it, right? So you have a wick right there. Another candle forms right here and it goes up and wicks this too. But then it comes down and form like this. We call this a bearish engulfing candle. This is your entrance, and you stay in it for 10 pips, multiple positions.